Durag Wisdom, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Earth Day Y2K20.03.25, the year of the CV19 pandemic. I have some message boards that I want to answer, and I will take care of those before I start a new broadcast next week. I apologize about the way the schedule is. In fact, I have to do nighttime. I usually make these during the day, but my wife is home. She's doing work from home now, so I have to adjust my schedule. And since I believe in something called adapt and survive, and that's, I believe I'm following a Marine Corps dictum. And even though I've never been in the military, I have a lot of respect for those in it, and especially the Marine Corps. The Navy too, because I love being on a ship. So I'll make sure before next week, like next week sometime, to answer these message boards before I make the new broadcasts. By the way, I'm wearing this hat. It's a green hat. You saw this before on my last broadcast. This is in honor of St. Patrick's Day. Full disclosure, I'm Jewish, and I live on a planet where we have a variety of people, a tapestry, if you will, of all kind, a collage. I used to love doing collages for my school yearbook, and one of my bucket list items is to spend a month in Ireland. Love the music, the people, and this hat that I'm wearing is in honor of this holiday, St. Patrick's Day, one of my favorites, that was interrupted by this villainous monster, this CV19 pandemic. Also, fake Senate impeachment trial, no vindication, no adjudication, no exoneration. Repeat. The music score you hear in the background is from Chinatown. This is the full cut by Jerry Goldsmith. I've been reading A Stable Genius by the Washington Post journalists Philip Rucker and Carol D. Leoning. And both of them give written documentation about what I've known about Trump all along. He is, among other things, a schoolyard bully. I'm extremely knowledgeable about bullies since I've had to deal with them throughout my life. How about a little bit of PTSD from it? Just because you graduate and leave the schoolyard does not mean that you will never have to deal with bullies again. When you enter the world of work, you enter a new, more sophisticated playground. Still contaminated by bullies. While reading A Stable Genius, I would flash back on those dark days of the rule of bully bastards. Again, Trump is a bully bastard. And it's one of the reasons why I have a special hatred for him. Whether you are blue or white collar workers, whether you are a professional such as a teacher, police officer, firefighter, sanitation worker, or transit worker, unless you are lucky to work for yourself, you are going to have to deal with the bully of the workplace. The supervisor, the superintendent, the manager, the boss, and the boss of bosses. You know, I remember for one summer at a beach club, I heard a moron refer to God, quote unquote, as the boss. The boss. I was naive to ever think that I would be free of the boss. In our boot camp culture and our boot camp civilization, where we are adept at making each other as miserable as possible, the boss is a vital commodity. They say that power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. Each boss you have to deal with will fundamentally embrace power with a gusto and rule over you with sadistic impunity. Don't get me wrong. I know that running a company and making money is a blood-draining concern. I've actually had the pleasure, far and few between, of working for decent human beings. But for the most part, the boss is a bastard. And I hate the boss. Hate the bully, the legal bully of that workplace. When I was a teacher, I was ironically put in the position of being the boss of the classroom. I love that word irony. More about that later. I despise most authority. I can't stand having to take orders from anyone. You know, it's from the bullying. You know, it's all part of that reaction. You hear? I was having to order children around. I could lose my job if I didn't, and you can be sure I did what I had to do, but in a responsible and humane and respectful manner for the most part. Because I've had students who come back to me who liked me, and some who didn't. I could never understand why people in this country wanted the creep Traitor Trump Cheeto to be president of our country. The epitome of the nasty boss. The epitome of everything I despise in bosses and in bullies in general. Reading A Stable Genius confirmed everything I knew about Trump ever since I first became aware of him as a transplanted New Yorker from Los Angeles. I arrived here in 1974. That's June. And first became aware of the living pile of vomit in 1978 or 79. The book, among other things, this is the book, The Stable Genius, is a document on how rotten Trump treats the people who work for him, and by extension, for us. Because if he has contempt for his workers, he also has contempt for us. And I know he does. Why would anyone want to encourage people during a science fiction pandemic to go out, go to church or whatever, mix with people, and die? Trump treats the people who work for him, and by extension for us, once again. He screams at subordinates in front of others. He tweets nasty crap about those who displease him. He insults with bully fake humor those he is afraid of, because this monster does not have a sense of humor. I've seen that behavior in bosses throughout my life, how they can get people to gang up on you. I've seen that. I've been a victim of that. Only they, the boss, are allowed to be in a bad mood. Only they are allowed to set up Kafka-esque rules and work routines. Like this one is doing. Never know what he's going to do next. Unpredictable chaos. I would never, folks, be able to work for someone like Traitor Trump. Because, again, I've had my lifetime fill of bullies. I could imagine the first time he'd raise his voice to me or otherwise denigrate my human dignity, I would tell him to go and screw himself, and I would be much more nastier than that. And I would take being fired with pride, although I would try to quit first to deny him the pleasure. But I would never, ever let him treat me with indignity, like he's doing to all these people. Read A Stable Genius, an ironic title. Read it. See how nasty, how disrespectful he is of fellow human beings. And when he stands in front of these people at his rallies, he's laughing at them like Lonesome Rhodes did in that movie, A Face in the Crowd. I find myself feeling sorry for some, but not all of the people who have to work for Trump. As for his sycophants, I care little of what he says to them because they deserve what they got. And that brings us to the heroic Dr. Anthony Fauci. He has been the director and expert on infectious diseases since the time of Reagan. He is still one of the medical professionals giving us the most valid information during the Traitor Trump Vid 45 updates. Dr. Fauci is diminutive in stature. So when he stands next to the 6'4" Hulk monster, Traitor Trump, the contrast cannot be starker. If anything, and ironically enough, it is the small-statured person who should be president of our country instead of the hulking giant. Dr. Fauci has more intelligence in his smaller-sized head than Trump has in his entire body. And on top of that, Dr. Fauci does not let Trump get away, heroically get away with giving us misinformation that will murder us. So I was upset when I did not see Dr. Fauci at a recent press conference. I didn't watch the press conference today, so I don't know if he was there or not. But his absence made me feel very uncomfortable. I hope that I am wrong, but Trump may get rid of Dr. Fauci because he is a sociopathic bully who hopes to one day be dictator of our formerly free country. He only wants sycophants around him once again, those that cowardly encourage his baser instincts. Dr. Fauci is not one of those. And if Traitor Trump gets rid of him, beware, friends. People visit here, please beware. In this year of the CV-19 pandemic, only listen to the scientists, the experts, the true, dedicated professionals. Do not listen to the bully in charge of our country. Once again, his advice is going to murder us. Murder a loved one. And he doesn't care. Sociopaths only care for themselves. The Dr. Faucis of the world, those who stand up to bullies and speak blunt truth to power, will ultimately be our redeemers.